you're gonna pull those pistols or whistle Dixie.
Folks, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am your host, the Mighty Bjorn, and today for you, got another tabletop gaming video, and we're going to dive into the world of Tiny D6, because today I'm going to be discussing a bit about Tiny Gunslingers. Now, what I'm going to mostly be talking about is quick draw events, if you will, and this is a feature actually within Tiny Gunslingers itself. It's actually dealt with like a little mini game of blackjack, if you will, although it's got some additional special rules. I'm not going to cover too much about that here. I just want to give my opinions about that kind of thing. And it's kind of interesting, too, that it's like a little game of blackjack, as poker during the days of the Old West was actually was seriously taken. You know, essentially, being a card shark was a professional or a profession in the days of the Old West. As you can see here, got a picture of from the movie Tombstone, and Doc Holliday there was one of those professional gamblers, actually. And there was other professional gamblers in the days of the Old West, and poker games was actually taken very seriously. So yeah, kind of doing like a little mini game of blackjack that involves life or death. That's definitely an interesting way to do it. And actually, so much so with the life and death scenario here is that Wild Bill Hickok was actually shot in the back during a poker game. And actually, his hand is now known as the dead man's hand, which is aces over eights that you can see here. So just a little snippet of history about life and death and poker. But like I said, I always like to inject a little bit of history into my games wherever I can kind of fit it in at and try and give them a more real feel by going with the whole history thing. So I'm actually going to be talking about the history of quick drawing because, well, actually, this is going to be rather short. It's more or less a Hollywood thing, if you will. Another one of them Hollywoodisms I've talked about. With the gun belt video, well, the carry styles video I did a while ago when in relation to Tiny Gunslingers. And realistically, what we get is, when you go digging, is almost never. Basically, there's one really good example of an actual moment of like the kind of Hollywood two men staring at each other with pistols and taking shots until someone dies moments. And then there's a couple moments that kind of resembles that, and there's, but they're not kind of perfect. So it really is just a Hollywood romanticization, if you will, of the Old West. And the one case I'm going to discuss here is actually the case with Wild Bill Hickok. Yeah, I know, Wild Bill Hickok coming up for two different events in the same video. One is his death, and one is actually essentially a quick draw duel that had actually happened. It was actually a duel between Wild Bill Hickok and Davis Tutt. I think I pronounced that last name correctly. And it was in Springfield, Missouri on July 21st, 1865. And actually, interestingly enough, it seems like it might have been over a gambling dispute. So apparently the claim is that Hickok actually owed Tutt money. Maybe it's Toot. I'm not quite sure. But the gambling dispute ended more or less in a gunfight that actually happened in the middle of the town square. Apparently, Looking into the history, Wild Bill Hickok was on one side of the town square. Davis was on the other side of the town square. And basically, the reports indicate, like, the reports are really foggy, but the only thing for certain is that Davis actually had drawn first on Wild Bill Hickok. Wild Bill Hickok was quick to also draw his pistol, and it sounds like two shots was fired, one from Davis, which completely missed Wild Bill Hickok, and then the following shot was from Wild Bill Hickok himself, and he had shot Davis actually square in the heart at apparently 75 yards. So that's a pretty decent range, especially for a pistol of that time. And there's even, now understand there's a lot of mystique and a lot of mystery behind this shooting, because like one thing that's also reported is that Wild Bill Hickok used Colt Walkers. But then there's others that indicate he actually probably used Colt Navies, which is it would have been a more modern pistol at the time. It's also a smaller caliber bullet. No matter which way you look at it, the dispute would end with Davis dying, because obviously he got shot in the heart, and Wild Bill Hickok would go on to become a legend, which he already kind of had a legend growing about him at this point. This just kind of made his legend more prominent, if you will. So what does this mean for quick draw duels? Well, basically what it means is, like I said, it's a Hollywoodism. This is literally the one case, and it's probably the most perfect case that you can consider of the Hollywood gun duel that you see in those old Western movies. So these, you know, movies like The Quick and the Dead in particular, where most of the movie is, you know, quick draw gun duels, just really didn't happen that often. Or at all, realistically. Now, there's a couple other cases that you might be able to consider if you dig into them, but basically the most I found was like three that you can kind of consider within the realm of being a quick draw gunfight moment. So realistically, me personally, the approach I take is kind of like the approach that Red Dead Redemption 2 took, where, yes, there is quick draw gun duels, but there's actually not a lot of them throughout the game. More often than not, there really isn't any. I want to say there might be 10 throughout the whole game. And it's a quite lengthy game if you've ever actually played Red Dead Redemption 2. So with that being said, more or less, I just take and use it to spice things up, to make the game more interesting, instead of using it as a constant mechanic. Because the problem is, if you use it constantly, people start to expect that they're going to go into a quick draw type of gunfight duel. And realistically, I just kind of want to prompt them into it, so that way they're not expecting it. Kind of like the Spanish Inquisition, you can't expect it. But anyway, folks, I'm going to wrap today's video up at that. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. Thank you very much for tuning in, and have yourself a wonderful day.